Hi everyone, Mike here from Paessler. Today we're going to take a look at lookups in PRTG and how you can start using them to personalise your monitoring. So firstly, what is a lookup? PRTG uses lookups to map values for channels in a sensor, which are then used to show the status of that sensor. A sensor can be in various states, such as up or down, but with lookups, you can display this data in a more friendly way. An example would be if you're using a sensor to monitor how much toner is left in your printer. Instead of the sensor telling you that the status is up or down, by using a custom lookup, you can display the state as toner low, for example. Much more friendly and informative. So, now that we know what lookups are, let's have a closer look at how we can use them in PRTG. So, to understand how lookups work, we're going to start in Windows. Lookups are defined by using XML formatted lookup files, which use the OVL extension, and they're stored in the lookup subfolder of your PRTG program directory. So let's have a look on the Windows level and find out where PRTG stores the lookup files so you know where to look if you want to use them and potentially customize them. So I'm looking at the local C drive here, which is where my PRTG instance is installed. That obviously might change for your instance, but we're going to go with the C drive for today. So let's look in the program files x86 folder, PRTG network monitor, and then here we find the lookups folder. And here we go, all the lookups that PRTG comes with pre-made. There's a lot of options here that you can use. For all the popular vendors, we've got Cisco and Dell, HP, Fujitsu. There's all sorts of options that you can use to get started with lookups. One of the best ways to practice and get better with it is just literally copy these templates and adapt them for your own needs. It's a wonderful way, easy way to get started, so I'd recommend you try that out. So now we know where PRTG stores its lookups, let's have a look in PRTG itself so we can see how the sensor uses them. So we're going to switch to our PRTG instance. And right now here, I've got an example device. It's a printer. And as I mentioned before, one perfect example of using a lookup would be how to show the toner status on a channel. So currently, we can see in our printer status sensor here, we've got a toner channel, and that's currently returning a value from the device of 1. Now, that doesn't really mean very much to us right now. It makes no sense for this channel state. I mean, does that mean there is a toner, there isn't a toner? Does it need replacing? We would like a bit more information on that. So we're going to use lookups to give us some more helpful, friendly information here. So in order to do that, we're going to click on the edit channel settings button here, which is the small gear, and that's going to allow us to edit the channel. So the default here is enable alerts based on lookups. You can obviously change it to alerts based on limits, but today we're talking about lookups, so let's leave it as that. Then PRTG wants to know which lookup file to use, so we're going to select that, and there we can see all the lookups that we just saw in the lookups folder. And there just happens to be one here that we can use for our HP printers. So it's the OID Paessler HP LaserJet Toner Status. So we're going to select that. Now, just before we apply that to our custom SNMP sensor, let's go back to the Windows level and we'll have a look at the lookup itself, just so you can get some context of what it's actually doing when we use it. So here is the lookup that we just selected, OID Paessler HP LaserJet Toner Status. So let's edit that with Notepad. So here we can see, as I mentioned before, lookup files are XML based. So here's all our lovely XML code. And what's happening here? There's not that many lines, only 14 lines of code here, so it's not too crazy. But we've basically got three values that are being defined from the device should it return one of them. So we've got a value of 0, we've got a value of 1, and we've got a value of 2. So I know my printer returns one of those three values depending on what the toner status is. So for 0, the toner looks okay. If it's a 1, which we remember that's what the device is returning at the moment, that means the toner is low. 2 is no toner cartridge loaded at all. So Currently, the sensor, as it was, it's not really useful to us because it's all green and happy and telling us that everything's all right, but that's not true. The toner is actually low. So now we know how the XML file is translating that information. Let's go back to our PRTG instance and now let's apply that lookup file, and as if by magic, now we have some actual useful information here. So we can see our toner channel now can give us three options. We've got the toner looks good, there's no toner cartridge loaded at all, or the toner is low, which when we can set up some triggers, notification triggers, to send us alerts as we need, so we can actually change the toner when it needs to be changed. So much more helpful, much more informative, and a great example of how you can use lookups in your instance. So now we've had our first use case of how to use a lookup in PRTG and how to apply that to an SNMP custom sensor to make your life a bit more easier. Let's go for something a little bit more in depth. So now we're going to use the REST Custom V2 sensor to query the status of a probe. Now this was actually a real live use case that one of our customers inquired about. So this is quite an interesting example. Let's show you in PRTG. So I've got my device here. I'm going to add a sensor, and we're going to search for the REST Custom V2. So here we go. Let's go through setting up our sensor here. So as I said, the purpose of this sensor is to use PRTG's API V2 to query the status of a sensor, whether it's active or inactive. So let's call our sensor probe state. The request URL here is the API call that we're going to use, and that's going to give us an active or inactive response. Then the channel that we're going to add is going to be $ASIC.active. And now we're going to set the channel type to user lookup, because that's obviously what we're trying to achieve here. So let's create our sensor. Oh, missing channel name. Create. So here's our new REST sensor. Let's give PRTG a couple of seconds. There we go. Right, so the API call is working. Let's set our probe state to be our primary channel. So now we have our REST sensor with the probe state set as the primary channel. We've got the sensor is same problem as before. It's returning a value of one. It could be zero or one, but right now that means absolutely nothing to us. Is the probe up? Is the probe down? We don't know. So we want to use a lookup to make that information a bit more obvious. So as before, I'd like to show you the lookup that we're going to use so you can understand the values that we're dealing with. So let's hop back into the Windows level. And this time, the lookup file we're going to use is the active inactive state. So let's open that with Notepad. So here we go. XML again. Even less lines than before, so this one's a bit more simple. And this is only dealing with two values here. The probe state, the value of 1, and the value of 2. Value of 1 is okay. The value of 2 is in error. So we're dealing with up or down, basically. So now we know what that's going to look like. Let's apply that in PRTG. So as before, let's go to the edit channel settings. Let's pop down to the lookup section, and this time we're going to apply the standard lookups, active inactive, there like that. And again, so much more helpful and useful to really help your monitoring show you what you need to be shown. The probe is active. Obviously, if it returns a different ID, then it's going to alert you if you set up the correct notifications. Really, really helpful. And it's such a helpful way to, like I said, make your monitoring more complete and effective to really let you know what's going on in your network. So that gives you a general idea of how you can use lookups to give your monitoring a more personalized feel. What we saw today was just two examples of how lookups could be used, but you could also use lookups to define so many things, such as a power supply status or the health of a logical disk, as well as many, many more. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to give us a like and subscribe below, and I'll see you next time.